Next, ECG. ECG means electrocardiogram. In German, ECG also called EKG, electrocardiogram. Electrocardiogram means the graphical representation of electrical activity of the heart during cardiac cycle. Electrocardiogram means the graphical representation of the electrical activity of the heart during cardiac cycle. It is a graph. Electrocardiograph is a machine. Electrocardiogram is a paper. To obtain a standard ECG, patient connect with machine by three leads. Two are attached with the wrist and one are attached with the left ankle. Multiple leads are attached to the chest region for better evaluation of the heartbeats. Next, in ECG, is the basal line. The peaks of the ECG indicates the PQRST, that is, P indicates atrial depolarization. QRS complex. QRS complex indicates ventricular depolarization. T wave indicates ventricular repolarization. Repolarization. P wave, this is P wave. SA node initiate the impulse. These impulse travels entire ventricles. The peak of the P wave and Q wave is called PQ interval. PQ interval causes the depolarization of atria. Depolarization means contraction of atria. Starting of the P wave indicates the SA node initiate the impulse. These impulse spread entire atria. This causes atrial systole. PQ interval indicates the depolarization of atria. Totally, P wave indicates the depolarization of atria. Next, QRS complex. This is QRS complex. QRS complex indicates the ventricular depolarization. It means ventricular systole, ventricular systole or ventricular contraction. Ventricular contraction starts after the Q wave. Ventricular contraction starts after the Q wave. QR interval. The peak of the R and the Q indicates the QR interval. It indicates the impulse. The impulse starts from the AV node to entire ventricular wall by the Purkinje fibers. Next, RS interval. This is RS interval. RS interval, it is ST interval. ST interval. These two indicates, RS interval and ST interval indicates the ventricular depolarization. Ventricular depolarization. Totally QRS complex indicates the ventricular contraction or ventricular depolarization. This indicates 0.3 seconds. The duration of ventricles is 0.3 seconds. PQ interval is 0.1 second. Next, T wave. T wave indicates the repolarization of ventricle. It means relaxation of ventricles. T wave indicates the relaxation or repolarization of ventricle. End of the T wave indicates the end of the systole. QRS complex indicates the first heart sound because of the QRS indicates ventricular depolarization, ventricular systole. Ventricular systole causes first heart sound. T wave indicates the second heart sound. Generally, all persons have same peaks, same ECG. But any deviation from these peaks indicates the abnormalities of the hearts. Any deviation in the peaks indicates the abnormalities in the hearts. The peaks of the P wave, R wave and T. P, R, T are positive waves. These are above the baseline. Below the baseline are Q and S. These are present below the baseline. Above the baseline are P, R, T. These are the positive waves. Below the baseline, Q and S are negative waves. In cardiac arrest, the sound is PPP sound indicates the cardiac arrest. This is the ECG. Double circulation. double circulation. In double circulation, right atria receives deoxygenated blood from vena cava. Left atria receives oxygenated blood from the pulmonary veins. Pulmonary veins. First, pulmonary circulation. Right ventricle pumps blood into the pulmonary arches. These enters into the, it opens into the pulmonary arteries, pulmonary arterioles, and capillaries into lungs. This blood is oxygenated in the lungs and then it enters into the venules, veins, enters into the venules and pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein sends into the right atria. Pulmonary vein sends into the oxygenated blood into the right atria. This circulation is called pulmonary circulation. This is lesser circulation. Lesser circulation or pulmonary circulation. Next, greater circulation. Greater circulation or systemic circulation. Lesser circulation or pulmonary circulation. Greater circulation or systemic circulation. In systemic circulation, oxygenated blood from the left ventricle pumps into the aorta and then enters into the systemic arteries, arterioles and capillaries, and then it enters into the tissues. The deoxygenated blood collects from the tissues into venules, veins, systemic venules, systemic veins and caval vein. Caval veins are vena cava. This is the systemic circulation. Systemic circulation starts from left ventricle to vena cava. It receives into the right atria. Systemic circulation starts from left ventricle to ends with right atria. Pulmonary circulation starts from right ventricle to left atria. These are the double circulation. Double circulation includes pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation. Special circulation is present in the heart. These are hepatic portal circulation. Hepatic portal circulation and coronary circulation. Coronary circulation. Hepatic portal veins means vessel starts with the capillaries and ends with the capillaries. These are called hepatic portal veins. Hepatic portal veins collect blood from intestine to liver before they enter into the heart. Before they enter into the systemic circulation. Absorbed substance present in the intestine or enters into the liver. The excess substance are converted into the glycogen in the liver. Next, coronary circulation. A specialized circulation present in the human heart. Next, coronary circulation. Coronary circulation is a specialized circulation present in the humans. Coronary circulation is circulation of blood to and from the heart or cardiac muscles. Coronary circulation contains two arteries, these are right and left, four veins. These four veins opens into coronary sinus. This coronary sinus opens into right atrium. These are the specialized circulatory systems in the humans. Systemic circulation provides nutrients, oxygen and other substance to the tissues, and it collects CO2 and other substance for the elimination.